about you. Why? Well, here's one reason why. When I was deployed to the Middle East in 2009, I became great friends with Major Tarek, the security officer at Kuwait Naval Base. I asked him how he learned how to speak English. He said that he learned through watching television. When he learned that we were from Hawaii, he said, "I love Hawaii," but he had not visited Hawaii. So how did he learn to love paradise a half a world away from Kuwait? He said, "Hawaii Five-O." I watched Hawaii Five-O. There are millions of people just like Major Tarek not watching the new Five-O. As the legislature grapples with its $1.3 billion deficit in the tourism industry, now struggling with the effects of the recent tsunami, we applaud the efforts of CBS and the producers, cast and crew of Hawaii Five-O. Your ability to touch every corner of the globe is priceless. The tourism promotional value that Hawaii Five-O provides is incredible and mind-boggling. In the words of the late James MacArthur, I too am heartened to see the legacy of this popular cultural icon preserved and perpetuated in the hands of terrific people now and then. Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I defer to the representative from Waimea.
Representative Christie.
Thank you, Speaker. I'd like to take a moment to introduce our honorees from the floor today. The first is Mr. Glenn Geller, Senior Vice President of Current Programming for CBS Television Studios, who has overseen primetime series activities for the studio since 2006. He began his career at CBS in 2001 as the Director of Current Programming, and prior to joining CBS, Mr. Geller spent 3 years at 20th Century Fox developing new pilots and working on such hits as The X-Files and Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Next to him is Hawaii Five-O's executive producer, Mr. Peter Lenkoff. Mr. Lenkoff is a native of Montreal, Canada, and has been writing, producer of movies and television shows for nearly 20 years. Prior to his work on Hawaii Five-O, Mr. Lenkoff served as executive producer on CSI New York, for which he won the Media Access Award 24, which earned him an Emmy nomination for Best TV Series, The District, and La Femme Nikita. On the big screen, he has written and produced several films, including Demolition Man, Son-in-Law, and The Jury. The next two honorees joining us this afternoon need a little introduction. Mr. Alex O'Loughlin has been busy busting bad guys as the reincarnation of veteran cop Steve McGarrett. Born in Canberra, Australia, Mr. O'Loughlin first charmed audiences with a starring role in the vampire drama The Moonlight. He was most recently seen on the big screen in The Backup Plan, starring opposite Jennifer Lopez. When he's not on set, Mr. O'Loughlin acts as an even more important role model, and through his activity involved in the charity Donate Life, whose mission is to educate the public on the importance of organ donation. Welcome. This honoree is no stranger to these islands, first with his role in the television series Lost, and then as a restaurateur of delicious handcrafted burgers, and now as Chip Hope Kelly on Hawaii Five-O. Mr. Daniel Dae Kim. His film credits include roles in The Hulk and Spider-Man 2, as well as the Academy Award-winning Crash. Most recently, he completed production on The Adjustment Bureau with Matt Damon. On television, Mr. Kim has had numerous guest-starring roles on shows such as CSI and ER. This past summer, Mr. Kim took the stage as the King of Siam in the iconic production of The King and I at London's world-renowned Royal Albert Hall. When he's not taking down boys' underground crime business as Chip Hope Kelly, Mr. Kim devotes much of his free time to a number of different charities and causes throughout these islands. Most recently, Mr. Kim lent his star power to the Actors and Artists Fund launch party for the Honolulu Theater for You. Was to write a bill creating a department to run drug interdiction that was accountable directly to the governor. And of course, the first thing that popped into my head was, well, let's just call it 5-0. How iconic is that? The question. What is that? That 25 years after the first show wrapped, someone like me who wasn't even alive when it was on the air knew exactly what that was all about. It's a legacy. And that's the enduring legacy that this production has. And I want to just thank the current cast and crew, not only for bringing such renewed attention to Hawaii, but for sharing O'Loughlin with the world. Congratulations.